Sure protection for the righteous. That's the title for the. It's the same thing. So if you were here on Sunday last week, and you are here, you were here on Friday, that's bonus. And you are here again this afternoon, that's come. Praise the Lord. Sure protection for the righteous. We look at that word sure and surely. In Psalm 23, it says surely, without any iota of doubt, goodness and mercy shall follow me some days of my life, all the days of my life. This is not a case of caring as needed. This is routine, all the days of my life. Sure protection for the righteous. The wind might be boisterous out there. Sure protection for the righteous. There might be mudslide, and the earth is opening up, swallowing people. The righteous cannot fall into it. God will not allow the lot of the wicked to fall upon the righteous. Is that what the Bible said? It cannot happen. Because the eyes of the Lord is always upon the righteous. Keeping watch over you, keeping watch over me, keeping watch over. So why will God he that keepeth Israel neither what? Sleep nor slumbers. Therefore, when the evil is coming upon the wicked, the righteous is surely secured. Sure protection for the righteous. The thing is that you got to make sure that you are born again. You are living a holy life. Virus or no virus, flu or no flu. When flu comes, it was flu. Go to CVS, take flu shot. Now something bigger than flu is here. It has defined solution. The world doesn't know how to handle it. Like I said, men's hearts are failing there. The world economy is tumbling down. They were asking the man in charge of treasury, "Are we not getting into recession?" There is recession already. And the man was dancing it this way and trying to avoid this way and pushing it to the medical people. No, that's recession. When the value of stock have gone down to almost how many percent? There is recession already. And the Bible said men's heart will fail them. For you are okay because your treasure is in heaven. But for people who have invested everything of their life on stock and this and this and this, like the man who harvested plenteously and said, "Today, no more." Men's heart are failing them. We have the joy and smile on our face to come to church. Some people, they are looking at the world door. They are calculating how much have they lost. How much have they lost? Because that's not enough. Sure protection for the righteous. That if it happens, they say, "Lord, if it is now, I'm ready to go. Let's go." The name of the Lord is a strong tower. Righteous ones into it, and they are saved. That's the Bible. The unrighteous have no tower, no place to run. They are like the generation of Noah. They didn't take that man. See, for 150 years, the man was building and preaching the picture of righteousness. They didn't take him serious until the day God shut down the door and took the key of the ark and opened the heavens and the deluge. Opened this one, and they were caught in between. Now they knew where Noah is. Uncle Noah, Baba Noah, can you open? Say, the owner of the ark shut the door and took the key away. Nobody has his own key. Jesus has it. I have Kiki of David. When I quench him, nobody can unquench it. God has his own key. And God unlocked the key and allowed the virus to get in. It is only you and I that are protected, that can cry unto God and say, Father, have mercy. Otherwise, the rate this thing is going, if the Lord does not intervene because of our prayer, in the next one, would you see the number of people the devil will successfully carry and put in hell? And that's what they started. But we will stop it in Jesus' name. Sure protection for the righteous. Point number one, divine protection for the righteous. I've already treated it already. If you are born again, and you know that your name is written in the Lamb's Book of Life, and you are constantly abiding, let me give you an illustration. In the Old Testament, I think in Numbers chapter 20, 35, God made provision for the city of refuge. If somebody kills somebody accidentally, he runs to that city of refuge. And he's expected to remain there. If he ventures out and the avenger catches him, fear, the avenger will kill him. The blood of the person will be upon himself and not upon the avenger. And he's supposed to remain in that city until the death of the high priest. Jesus is the refuge. You run into it, you are safe. The Bible says our life is hid in Christ with God. Therefore, who is the devil? No weapon formed against us shall prosper. We are the joke of the present dispensation. God bless that man. Really good. Apart from physical blessing, God put a fence and hedge round about you. You can't build a house if you want protection from armed robbers without putting a fence. Am I right? That's how God does it for us. Once you are born again, he will build that fence round about you. He did it for Job, and the devil was so jealous. God said, have you seen my servant Job? There is none like him on the face of it. Who is this and that? And then the devil said, does Job praise and worship you for naught? You have blessed him, you have done everything. And finally, you have put an edge round about him. Well, so why wouldn't he bless you? God has put an hedge round about us that there is no way coronavirus can affect and attack a child of God. Impossible. As long as the promises of God are there and you are constantly abiding, living in holiness, Jesus Christ turned around and told him, the prince of this world cometh and found something in me. Found nothing in me. Stand on the promises of God. Live holily and righteously. He declared as if the prince of this world cometh. He's always there. He findeth nothing in me. I don't own the property of the devil. If you're holding the property of the devil, you have given the devil. But if you're living with, and you don't own any property of the devil on you, around you, in your house, he cannot. He doesn't have any permission to come. Divine protection for the godly. Point number two. I told you we are going to make a summary. Divine connection for the righteous in times of affliction. Divine connection for the righteous in times of affliction. Brethren, God has the power to do everything. He said, just leave it for me. There are times that God does something directly for his own glory. There are times that God also appoints divine helpers and places them on your way. People that will see you, they don't know you from Adam. They just take interest in your case. And they will fight for you, divine helpers. If it is an unbeliever, fine. If it is a believer, fine. If it is an unbeliever, like Rahab, and then like zip your mouth. In times of affliction, it's either you do that or you appoint somebody to go and serve and take care of my child. In Genesis chapter 35, I think verse 17 or so, Joseph was sent to take care of his brother. He got there at Shechem to find them. He was roaming about until he saw a man. I said, what are you looking for? I'm looking for my brethren. I can't find them there in Shechem. Do you know where they are? Oh, I heard them say, let us go to daughter. Whether that man is an angel, I don't know. Joseph turned around and found his brethren in daughter. Divine connection. The Lord will do it for us in Jesus' name. Mm-hmm. Now look at the life of David. Look at all that Saul was doing to kill him. Look at, see how God used Saul's son. Divine connection. Look at how God used Saul's daughter, Michal, to protect and preserve the life of David. Divine connection. Right in Saul's own house, that Jonathan became an advocate and an intercessor. And like our teacher taught us this morning, that intercessory prayer and that advocate was answered. So I said, okay, I will not slay him anymore. The evil spirit came again. It came on his throne. What is he doing with Jacqueline in his life? Away in the war from him. King, with all his royal regalia, and said, what is he doing with Jacqueline? Inside the heart, he still brought him to kill that young man. There's no room for him to hold Jacqueline in his hand. And the young man was there. Doing his duty, playing it so that as a fiam, the thing went through the wall. After that, he said, go get him in his house. Michal said, I know you are my dad, but this is my husband. For this reason, a man shall leave his father and mother and be joined to his wife. I've left you, dad. This is my husband. I won't let you kill him unnecessarily. He has not done anything evil. Honey, through the window, take off. Divine connection for the righteous in times of affliction. As we, did she not tell lies? Forget about whether she told lies or not. That's the Old Testament. I don't know whether she was born again. I'm not going to judge her. The man escaped. At another time, she just made a dolly dolly on the bed. Divine connection. Somebody would just go through the office file. Why didn't they employ this person? A new human resources manager was going through old files and they were looking for people to hire. This person is qualified, even overqualified. Why didn't they employ her? Hey, ma'am, are you still interested in this job? He said, yeah, I'm in the train. Can you come? When are you coming in? Tomorrow by 9 o'clock. The woman came. And she saw her, a Christian. That's why they didn't tell you, I will give you this job. But she didn't wear that one to slice this one. The woman dressed in really Christian. I know, seeing you, I know why they didn't employ you. I will give you this job. That's how the sister got the job. Divine helper. Meanwhile, those people that come and say, when they did the interview, as this one is those people that carry back, God wiped them away from that place of love. So, God has the capacity to appoint somebody and say, go. Do this for me for my child. I had this story of a young Christian. He was praying, he had a accommodation, he didn't have furniture. He didn't have the money. He continued to pray unto God, say, Father, you give me an accommodation. You wish he had a blessing. And God spoke to somebody in another state. Say, this is the name, this is the address. This is the type of furniture I want you to buy. Buy this furniture, put it. This is the true life story somebody told me. This brother was in Lagos. The person that God spoke to was in Benin. And you know that in Benin you have the best of furniture. Am I right? In Benin, you have the best of furniture. The brother said, what did I exactly? God told you. The name go to, this is the name, this is the address. Champion. In 911. Straight to Lagos. Got there, knocked. So I'm the person who will come. Carry. He said, listen, don't ask any question. I'm doing what God told me to do. That's the furniture. God is able to do all things. This to another person went to was out of doesn't have paper. It's like the two lepers. If I stay here, if we fall to the Samaritans, they will kill us. It doesn't make any difference. If we go back into the city, there is one. No, it does not, the death is already there. Let's go. The person went to the immigration. This is my situation. What do you have? What do you want to do with me? To slaughter me, or say, do you know what you are talking about? I say, I know what I'm talking about. Do you know the criminal code you have? He said, I know. You sure? Stay there. God is able to do all things, brethren. I tell you the truth, I lie not. That one that's made the boss in their midst. God can send somebody, you go on vacation. Then the person that was in like, this one. They will call you what you desire. Divine connection for the righteous in times of affliction. God will do it for us in Jesus' name. I said, God Almighty, He will do it for us in Jesus' name. Yeah. Point number three, prayer for the nation. We were told to pray for the nation. And we're doing that. We did that extensively on Friday. We read Psalm 91 from verses 1 to the end. We called upon the name of the Lord. We say, God, remember Mark chapter 13, verse 20. For the elect's sake, it's only because of you and I that God, the wrath of God will be blessed. Otherwise, this thing will take a reasonable percentage of the world's population. He did it in Sodom and Gomorrah. He wiped them away. It's the same sin that Sodom and Gomorrah committed that the whole world is committing. No wonder Billy Graham, when he was arrested, if God does not punish America, God will appear to Sodom and Gomorrah and apologize to them. Many years ago, that man foresaw what was happening. He said, if God does not punish America for their sin, that God will have to apologize to Sodom and Gomorrah for wiping them away. The same sin then is the same sin now. In fact, it has grown worse now. How can human beings be related with animals? They say, hey, the saliva of the dog is more protein. The saliva of the dog is more proteinous. That's why they carry dog, big dogs. You think they do other things in darkness with those animals. Then after licking the saliva, they go and kiss the man with that. The chain of infection continues until it gets to a virus and virus the whole world. It's true. This coronavirus or whatever it is the reward of iniquity. Sin has gone viral in the world. I sought for a man stand in the gap to make the hedge. That's our assignment in public and in privacy. God, I'm standing in the gap as your child. Please stay action. For the elect's sake, shorten the days. Find solutions to this. The devil's plan is to take people away to hell earlier than scheduled. Maybe they will have given their life to Christ. A whole nation, Italy, to shut down, going on 1 week. A city of 60 million people shut down. Even here where we live now, there is self-restriction on movement. Except those that are essential, go to Walmart, but you're not going to see hand sanitizer. So we are going to buy other food items. Or go to work. Nobody goes on social visit. Stay in your house. You go out on the highway, very few vehicles. I say, people are like my lunch. So people can stay in their houses. You don't see them again when you are going to church. They will carry their truck and will carry their boat to go and fish. Because the guard people, I don't know what they call them. That one is also in his house. I'm on self-quarantine. It will take you and I, as children of God, and say, Father, please stay action. That's the assignment we have. Let's continue to pray. If my people that are called by me, he said, if I send pestilence, God sends pestilence. God is good, God is good all the time. Hey, there are times he sends pestilence. If I send pestilence and this and that and they devour my people, what if my people that are called by my name should humble themselves and pray and seek my face? Number one, I will hear from heaven. Number two, I will forgive their sin. Cause for worldwide repentance. I will hear their hand. That's the assignment we have. Sure protection for the righteous. The Lord will help us. In this time, in Jesus' name. Amen. The Lord will help us in this time, in Jesus' name.
Amen.
you have not forgotten what I said, our brother should go to the piano. GHS number 30. Sing that. Close and go. GHS 30. Yeah, we can do the lala and sing. Your voice not around. GHS 30. I think he wants to use last one. We can sing so that way.
La 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 la.
Thank you, Lord, for the answer. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
is over,